Of infinite variety has a history as rich and varied as the people who came to live here. On our South Dakota adventure, we'll be learning about the geographic formations that helped to shape South Dakota, the Missouri River Valley, the Badlands, the Black Hills, and even Bear Butte. And we'll learn about some colorful South Dakotans who helped shape our destiny. Potato Creek Johnny, Wild Bill Hickok, Calamity Jane, our first governor, Millette, and even Laura Ingalls Wilder. A day in South Dakota can be many things. A June day in South Dakota can be heaven on earth. The summer sun shining down from an endless blue sky. With friendly clouds floating on gentle, warm breezes over green fields of winter wheat and freshly sprouted corn. Young people play happily in the summer, free of heavy winter clothing. Older folks work in the garden or just sit. So in the land of infinite variety, every South Dakotan has the opportunity to enjoy a perfect June day. But the clouds gather, darken, and billow into thunderheads. The wind wails as it rises. Torrents of rain fill streams and gullies. Hail, tornadoes, and dust storms batter the land. South Dakota summers can be heaven or hell. Winter can be beautiful. Big, fluffy flakes fall into soft, powdery layers. But the Dakota winds can whip the snow into a blinding blizzard in minutes.
Sometimes it can be 114 degrees above zero.
Or as hot as minus 40.
But the slow, easy, warm days of autumn can make us forget freezing January and scorching July. This is a land of continual contrast, rich farmland, and the haunting beauty of the barren Badlands. Rolling prairies of long grass once covered the eastern part of the state to the shores of the Missouri River. The short grass plain of western South Dakota, dotted with sage and yucca, sweep up to the foothills of Pahasapa, the Black Hills.
South Dakota may well be right in the middle of things. The marker behind me, located a couple miles north of Pierre and on the road to the Owyhee Dam, marks the spot where historian Doane Robinson figured the geographic center of North America would fall. Well, other people, like the National Geographic Society, think that maybe that center would fall in North Dakota. But either way, a mathematical calculation of that size leaves plenty of margin for error. So it's generally agreed that this is a close enough approximation to the center of North America. It's for sure the center of South Dakota. And just over the ridge to the west, the Missouri River divides the state as it runs from North Dakota to Iowa, right in half.
Water in South Dakota is also found in glacial lakes, creeks, and streams with waterfalls. Man has created more lakes, by damming rivers. Plentiful wildlife abounds across our state. South Dakota, we have two different cultural groups in our state borders, Indians and non-Indians. Europeans came to South Dakota to settle from different ethnic and cultural backgrounds, and they get together to celebrate that history every year. There's a Snack Fest in Freeman, there's Czech Days in Tabor, and the Nordland Fest here at Augustana College in Sioux Falls. South Dakota's number one industry is agriculture. State's second largest industry. The Black Hills is the biggest attraction, but there are things for visitors to do all over the state.
When South Dakotans aren't working hard, they're playing and relaxing hard in many different ways. In summertime, there's boating, skiing, hiking, cave exploring in the Black Hills. In wintertime, there's ice skating, ice fishing, ice hockey, and snow skiing. There's horse races, boat races, dog races, and state fairs. An endless variety. Have added to South Dakota's natural variety by building churches, homes, and courthouses. Unique to the state is the Corn Palace at Mitchell. USD's landmark is the Dakota Dome. SDSU has the Campanile. And the state's largest city, Sioux Falls, houses the state prison and the state's largest airport. Men carved faces in mountain rock at Mount Rushmore. Still being sculpted is the huge monument of Crazy Horse near Custer. South Dakota's housing has varied from the Arikara dwellings along the Missouri and the portable Sioux teepee to the sod shanties of the white homesteaders. Early city dwellers built elegant mansions. Now, there are apartment buildings and solar homes. Yes, the passing years have brought a variety of changes to South Dakota. From the forests of the Black Hills to the treeless plains at South Dakota. With pasque flowers in May, wild plum and buffalo berries in summer. In the fall, goldenrod and bright red sumac. In the winter, a blanket of white. If you don't like the weather, just wait a minute. It'll be different. We're going to take a South Dakota adventure every week, and you're invited to the land of infinite variety.